Welcome back to the 2023 IPF World Open Equipped Powerlifting Championships in Druskininkai, Lithuania, brought to you by none other than Aleko and SPD. We have got the 63 kilo women and the 93 kilo B group men this afternoon, and of course that we followed this evening live on Eurosport by the A groups as well. We'll run this as two flights. We'll go through the 63 kilo women first, then straight into the 93 kilo men. And we are just about to get underway with Lina Grucha from Lithuania. And of course, this is probably a really tough session because they're in the B group and they won't actually find out where they sit overall until we do the A group later this evening. So it makes it a little bit tougher competition-wise for these guys because all they can do is put their numbers on. They've got no sort of real indication of where they're sitting until later. So we will go through the results at the end of each session as well, just so you can see where they're sitting in the B group. But right now, Lina Grucha from Lithuania, 125 kilos for her opening squat. And moving very well. Great opening squat. And that sort of opening squat filters through the rest of the group as well, reduces some nerves a little bit for the rest of the group about to come out. So, Lithuania again. Lemonti. Zirinskaitia. 140 kilos. Still in the juniors for a little bit longer yet. Here competing in the opens. That was a quick squat. Three white lights. And we're going to roll through these pretty quickly. There's only six lifters in this flight. We load up to 170 now for Caitlin Minicky from the USA. So opening at 170. Best squat of 160 last year in Viborg. It's a big improvement since then. The opening on 170. Moves quickly again. Three whites. We say a quick squat is often a good squat, but it's often a bit of a challenge in equipped wearing that squat suit. You've got to be able to control it all the way down through the lift. So 182.5 now for Melody Darman. In France. $167.5 at the Europeans earlier this year. And 180 in Viborg, so 182.5 opener. Depth is really good, but just didn't quite get the power out of the bottom. Let's have a look at the replay here. Sits in deep there. And just shifted it backwards a little bit, the suit pushing her around. And I'm sure Melody will fix that one up. Lucy Hart from Great Britain, 185. her first world championships. Got introduced to powerlifting in the Cambridge University Powerlifting Club. And it's been all up since then. It's really struggling to find the depth there. Be a tough call from the coach on this one, whether to put a couple more kilos on that to push down through the equipment a bit more. You can see at the bottom there, just really struggling to push through the squat suit and the wraps and forcing that right knee to fall in a little bit. Lauren Elder now from the Great British team as well. And Lauren's very accomplished lifter. She squatted 205 in Viborg last year, opening at 195. Finds the bottom. And wait for the referees on that one. It's two whites. Gets that on the board. Should be a lot more relaxed now. So not a lot of cut recovery time for this group. We're already into round two with Lina Grutia from Lithuania, 135. And a great opener at 125. Depth looks good again. A little bit of a fight through the middle there. But she gets the three whites. And she certainly doesn't have any issue with depth there. She gets right down into it. Hips popped up a little bit fast on that one. But she managed to regain. Demonte. Skaitja from Lithuania, 145. Oh, I think she might have cut that shy a little bit there. And we'll wait for the referees, but it looked a little bit shallow. Yeah, it is. She gets the three reds there, two red cards and a blue. The red for depth. So it's a bit of an instinct thing to do when you're not overly confident under the weight and you're not too sure. Pulling up short is the normal response. But in equipped lifting, it has the opposite effect quite often. So Caitlin Manicki now from USA, 177.5. Smooth all the way through. Three whites. Big breath to brace through the middle. Handles that suit well. So Lucy Hartnell, Great Britain, missed her opener at 185. They stayed at 185. And the issue really was pushing down through that suit. She has quite a wide stance, which makes it that little bit harder again. But she's in good hands. There's plenty of coaching experience out there on Team Great Britain. Just needs to sit back into it. looks better. That right knee still dropping in a little bit, but she pushed it back out and gets the white lights. And she'll be breathing a sigh of relief now. The Melody Darman, France. Also missed her opener 187.5 now. So Melody didn't get 182.5. Opted to throw on an extra few kilos there, which is not uncommon. Just to really get the most out of the equipment and push down through it. And it has worked very well. Big difference there. Three white lights. Happy with that one. And you can see the difference there. The extra weight just allowed the suit to go down a little bit easier and didn't push her around a bit. So Lauren Elder now. Great Britain, plenty of experience in Lauren, and the big Mike Gibson in her coaching corner today, an accomplished lifter himself. A little dip into the bottom to find depth, and she does, three whites. You can see that there's two lifts on the board. She's really starting to show the emotion a little bit, starting to relax a little. And we come round from round three already. Lina Garucha, Lithuania, 140 kilos. Lina has had two great squats already. And that one might not have been as deep as the others, but the others were very deep, so she might be okay. She is. Three from three. Get at 150 now, then Monty Junskaitia from Lithuania. Missed 145 on a second. And is stuck with the plan. Put another five on there. And that looked a lot better. She sunk into that one and gets the three whites. And you can see how much easier that bar came up. So Caitlin Manicki now, 182 and a half. Sinks down well. She's a fantastic smooth motion in her squat. Doesn't let that suit pull you around at all. So Lucy Hart looking for 192.5. Mr. Open at 185, corrected on her second. Now looking for 192.5, and this would be a very big personal best. She did 182.5 at European Western Europeans earlier this year. And 185 at Europeans, so 192.5. She's going to have to give it everything she's got. Oh, it looked better than her second. Her right knee stayed out on that one. As she got down, she has. It's deep enough. Much better lifting. You see the right knee there. Didn't drop as much. And she was able to generate a lot more power. And Melody Darman now from France, 192.5. Melody put up a 180 squat in Vibourg last year. Got a best lift of 187.5 listed. This is a big, big lift. And they've got those wraps super tight. And I think they got those wraps perfect. Good speed out of the bottom, but just unfortunately couldn't convert at the top. But a big effort. You can see out of the bottom there, good speed, but just couldn't keep it going, couldn't convert. So 205 now for Lauren Elder. This will equal her best lift in squats from Vibourg last year. A lot of work to find depth, but stands it up and she gets it on the board. 3 from 3, an absolutely fantastic effort. And there's the B group results for the 63 kilo women. Lauren Elder with 205, Lucy Hart 192.5. And of course, they're not going to find out where they sit overall until later this evening when we run the A group live on Eurosport. And right now we move it straight into the 93 kilo men with Leonardo Quiroz Lefes, 255 from Costa Rica. And again, these guys B group as well, so tough task to come out here and then have to sort of sit back and wait to see where you finish overall and see if you manage to get into the medals for any of the individual lifts. Looks like a good opener. It is three whites. And of course, the world record for the 93 kilo men, 405 kilos. And that was set by Nikki Lentz last year in Vivorg. So Claudius Levskis from Lithuania now, 295 kilos. What? handled that very well. Three whites, great depth.
Yes, they went right in front of him, wouldn't they?
Hugo Duarte now from Great Britain. Looking for 295. Put in a massive 350 at the Europeans earlier this year. Didn't register a squat at the Western Europeans. Oh, and that was an absolutely textbook squat. Gets to the bottom, dips in. Chest is up, head position does not move the whole way through. Great example of an equipped squat. Antonio Gorga from Italy now, 300 kilos. Moved very fast, as you'd expect, given he did a 325 earlier this year at the Europeans. So Matthew Hallett now from Great Britain, looking for 310. We have great news. The Mustache of Power has come back. We've determined that his best results are when he has the best mustache in the IPF. Depth looks good. Looks good from where I'm sitting. It is three whites. Alex Comble Orison from Iceland. Next lifter at 325. And again for these guys, seven people in this group, so it's a really quick turnaround. Competed in Viborg last year and didn't put on a total. And that was because of squats with 325, did not get his squat in. Yeah, 317 and a half at Europeans earlier this year. Let's see if he can put it together today on the world stage. He's got to replace command. I'm not quite sure what it was for. I think it was for his knees not being in the locked position. He's got his work cut out for him now. And he gets the squat command with 1 second to go. He has made it work. Has he got deep enough? He has. Somehow he managed to overcome the stress from that and made it work. He had 1 second left on the clock. The buzzer went half a second after he got the squat command. Adiyatmer Ingvatar from Mongolia, 325. think this might be his first World Championships. Not 100% sure on that. I can't recall seeing him lift. Well, he got plenty of depth there, but just couldn't convert. Probably a little bit too much depth. And I'd be looking to tighten those wraps a little bit, make a few little adjustments. But we come around to the second round now. So quick turnaround. So Otterson there on 325, Hallett 310, all got 300. And of course, Ingbata from Mongolia, not to put a squat on yet. Leonardo Quiros Lepes from Costa Rica, 270 kilos. He had a great opener at 255. Struggling a bit with the walkout and the setup there. Just can't find his balance. Still got 30 seconds on the clock. And he's found his spot now, he's tightened up. Great job from the spotters, and great job from the lifter as well there to really give the spotters the notification that this isn't going to happen. So Hugo Duarte now, Great Britain, 3:10. So he's playing a very mature plan today. I mean, this is well under his best lift, but for the last several competitions, he's failed to put on a total because he's missed his squats or he's missed his bench. But today, you can really see that he's really thinking attempt-wise, getting those numbers on the board, getting a total. Antonio Borga now from Italy. Oh, the jury has overturned that lift from Duarte, unfortunately. On depth. 320 on the bar from Antonio Borga. The good news for Duarte, though, he got his opener on the board, so he's in the right direction. Well, again, three whites. Claudius Malevskis, Lithuania, 320 kilos. Championship for a while. Gets another one on the board, looking very, very strong. Matthew Hallett for 325. So this will beat his best squat from Western Europeans this year, which was 320. And I think this will be his best squat to date at an international, of course. 325. He's on the board with 310. Good again, it is three whites. With your Tuma, Egbata, Mongolia, 325, missed his opening at 325, got there really deep. And I think that was probably the problem, was just too deep. And it looks like they've really tightened up those wraps a bit for this one. And I think that will make the difference. And he's had to fight, but he gets it to the top. I think it was deep enough. It is, and he gets it on the board. So all lifters on the board now. And we go to Alex Combray Rosen from Iceland. 337 and a half. He's got the strength. Did he get down enough, though? Hard to see from here. He did. He gets the two white lights. And loads of 270 for the next round. There's Orison there with the biggest spot in this group so far, 337.5. Leonardo Quiroz Lopez. And the jury has actually overruled that last lift in the last round on depth. So that was Orison, which is a no lift. But right now, Lopez from Costa Rica, 270. And just getting all out of sorts there. Had a lot of trouble on his second. And just couldn't manufacture that one today. And on his second lift, he just couldn't get his position right. Had to re-rack, unrack, set it up again, and just couldn't put it together. And the same again. Just couldn't find the line. Hugo Duarte now, Great Britain, 310. Opted to stay on 310. The jury overruled the last lift. But he has very, very good squat, great technique. Gets into position, he gets his chest up. He stays in that position, he sits back into it. He's made sure it's deep on that one. He's not leaving anything to chance there. And 2-1 at 310. Oh, and unfortunately, the jury has overruled that again. But he does have his first squat on the board, so he is on his way to making a total. Claudius Malevskis, Lithuania,
327.5.
He's had a bit of a moment of the wrong lifter coming out. Technical controller picked that up though. Out there, struggling to find the position, but he gets it now. And just a little bit too much for today. So Matthew Hallett now in Great Britain, 332.5. This will be a big personal best for him. Issue with the rack positioning there. And still got plenty of time. Happy to work, but it's just a little too much today. Big effort though, got into a good position, but just couldn't push it all the way through. I think he'll be pretty happy with today's effort though. So he stayed at 332.5. Bata now from Mongolia. Interesting choice. Opened at 325. Went down a bit too deep and really couldn't make it happen. Tightened up for 325 and made it work. Now going an extra 7.5 for 332.5. And a little bit ambitious, I think, for today's lift. We got 335 now. Antonio will go up from the 335. This lift at Worlds in Viborg was 320. Did a 325 earlier this year at the Europeans in Denmark. A big, big lift. Just struggling to find his balance position there. He's rushing it a little bit now, but I think he's found it. Again, just not able to find the balance. And he's not going to try and rush it a third time, which I think is a very wise decision. He's on the board with two other squats anyway, so he's on his way towards making a total. Alex Combray Orison from Iceland, 340. So he was unsuccessful at 337.5. And his extra couple of kilos, I think he's hoping will push him down through the equipment a little bit easier. He's handling the weight well. He was deeper that time, but not deep enough, unfortunately. So no joy there, but everyone is on the board with a squat. And Engbata there, 325, and Hallett, 325, the three biggest squats. Arison as well on 325 per this group. Don't go too far away. We'll be right back here in 10 minutes. We'll get the bench press sessions underway. Welcome back to Druskininkai, Lithuania, for the 2023 IPF World Open Equipped Powerlifting Championships, brought to you by none other than Aleko and SBD. And we are just about to get the 63 kilo women's B group bench press underway. And everyone on the right path to registering a total. Probably one of the toughest lifts in equipped here is bench. There's just so many things that can go wrong. It's also probably the most exciting because there's so many things you can do when things do go wrong. We start with Lina Grutia from Lithuania, 57.5. Had great squats today. And it looks like she's off to a great start on bench as well. Three whites. I'm guessing it's probably not her favorite lift. She's not traditionally built for bench. And then we load at 65 kilos. And Monty. Žurin Skotia, Lithuania, 65. Opening raw, no bench shirt. And three whites. So these first lifts, so important to put on the board. Now Great Britain, 85 kilos. She had 87.5 at the Europeans earlier in the year. This was her best lift from Vivorg. Of course, she's lifted well above that before. Just wants to put this one on the board. Gets the touch. Springs off. Drives it to the top, big lockout, and three white lights, and it's on the board, and she will be very, very happy with that. And bench hasn't always been a favorite. Lucy Hart, Great Britain. A bit of a rocky start on squats, and then managed to put things together. First World Championships. Right, just trying to get that lift off position. And a half kilos. And she managed to regain that really well. She has quite a straight down pull to the chest, whereas most people tend to land it more like an airplane. You can see that caused a few little issues there because the bar wants to push back, the shirt wants to push back. So Melody Darman now from France, 95 kilos. And this should be a fairly quick opener. Melody put up 102.5 in Vivorg last year and 105 at the Europeans last year. And it was quick. Got a red light and a red card from the centre referee. One elbow a little bit higher than the other there. So Caitlin Manicki now from US 120. I think her best international lift was in Vivor last year at 102.5. Hard touch there, but she gets it.
Yes.
And she gets the three whites. And we are already into the second round. A quick turnaround time. Not as tough on the bench as it is in squat, because you're not trying to take on equipment or take off and put on equipment. We're in the second round. Helena Grutia from Lithuania, 65 kilos. Shirt just playing havoc. She got good speed off the chest. Let's have a look at the replay. She gets a nice touch there. Speed off the chest is good. But that left arm accelerated so much faster than her right. Just made it difficult to keep it up. So Daimonti, Zrinskaitia. 67.5, so still lifting without a shirt. So in equipped lifting, you don't have to use the equipment. There's no rule that says you have to wear a bench shirt. And getting a bit harder now there, but successful lift at 67.5. Lauren Elder from Great Britain now looking for 90 kilos. And Mike Gibson handling there is actually a bench specialist. Competed at the World Championships in South Africa earlier this year. Gets the touch, gets the speed, but unfortunately that shirt decided to drive straight back into the rack. And I think that's just a little bit of technique adjustment for the next lift, and she'll have no problem with that. We have all had that happen to us in a bench shirt. So Lucy Hart, Great Britain, 100 kilos, doing well today. She got off to a rough start in her opening squat and then managed to put everything together again. Better touch point on that one. Can she lock the left arm? She does. Has she done enough? She gets two whites. Much better touch point on that lift compared to a first. So Melody Darman now. 102.5, just giving the spotters a quick little instruction of where she wants the bar lifted off to. Of course, those guys doing a great job this week. Finds the spot. Oh, fantastic press. Three white lights. The speed of this press was absolutely fantastic. So Caitlin Manicki now, USA, 125. Got a great press command there. Yeah, if you can get the bar down to your chest and stop it quickly, you're going to get a quick press command. And the quicker you can get that command, the easier it is for you. So Lina Gurucha, Lithuania, 65 kilos. I'm wondering if Zhurin Skaitia will put a shirt on for the third lift. She has gone up to 75 kilos, and that 67.5 looked like it was getting tough. But right now, Lina Gurucha. Oh, just can't quite get it there. She did everything she could to lock out that right side. You can see her shoulders even lifting forward and rotating. Monty, Zhurin Skaitia, 75 kilos, still lifting raw, so that's a big jump. 7.5 kilos from 67.5 to 75 for a raw bench, particularly in this weight class. And just a little bit too ambitious, that extra 7.5 kilos. So Lauren Elder now, 90 kilos. Missed it on a second. She got a great touch. She got really good speed off the chest. But that shirt just drove her backwards. But I think they've made a good decision here to stay at 90 kilos. And I think he now has a feel for how that weight's going to come off her chest. Gets a nice touch. Good control. She's got it there. What do the referees say? Three white lights. She walked off not entirely happy with it. She gets it, but don't think she was entirely happy with the lift itself. So Lucy Hart now, 105 for Great Britain. She's been looking good on the bench. I'm sure all her friends are home watching her first world championship. And locks it to the top. Should be good. It is. She goes three from three on bench, which is an outstanding effort in any equipped competition, and even more outstanding than your first world championship and going three from three on bench. If I get one, I'm happy. Melody Darman, France, 112.5. And it looks good. It is. That is the most green I have seen on a bench score sheet ever. Caitlin Manicki now looking for 127.5. Which I think will be her best lift. It'll certainly be her best international lift. Touch, and she got some good speed off the chest, but having to work hard, and I think she's already lifted her butt off the bench. Unfortunately, just couldn't put that one together, but having a great day so far. So that brings us to the end of the 63 kilo women's bench press, and of course we'll move straight into the men's 93s. And Caitlin Manicki there with the best lift in this group, 125. Melody Darman, 112.5. And of course, Lucy Hart there, 105, three from three as well. A great result for her and everyone on the board on their way to solidifying a total. But right now, we move into the 93 kilo men. Leonardo Quiroz Lepes, Costa Rica, 165. And of course, both these groups are not going to know their overall standings until later this evening, after we run the A groups. And that is a great opening lift. And we rack to 180 for Antonio Giorgia from Italy. They lifted this same weight the Europeans earlier this year. Comes down awfully quickly, but he makes it work. Current world record is 351.5 by Konstantin Osienko. Alex Kombare-Orison, 200 kilos. Gets the touch. Gets it to the top. Didn't get a lot of speed off the chest. And it is a no lift. He's got three reds with blue cards, which is usually downward movement, which you can see there. Bit of a dip in the bar there. I think Bata, Mongolian out, 200 as well. Strong off the chest. Three whites.
Yes. A white flag for you. Good lead.
Good speed there and follows it through well. Hugo Duarte, Great Britain now, 217 and a half. He was strong on squats. He had great technique. Unfortunately, from the referee's side, just didn't get deep enough on a couple of them. And he'll be wanting to rectify this now. 217 and a half. Lifted this at the Europeans earlier this year, Western Europeans. Didn't get a bench in at the Europeans earlier this year. And he gets it to lockout. Has he got this one on the board? He has three white lights. They can't overturn that one. He is on his way to solidifying a total, which will be a great thing because for the last four Europeans and internationals, he has not put a total on. And he is on his way now. Claudius Malevski, Lithuania, 235. Good. Two whites. Let's have a look at the replay and see if we can catch with the red and the yellow card, because it's usually butt lift, but it could be head lift or foot movement. Yeah, and his head just hard to tell whether it actually left completely. It still may have been in contact when he gets the one red. Matthew Hallett now, Great Britain, 250. Looking good on squats. He was a gold medalist at the Western Europeans in the 105 kilo weight class this year. And you can just see the bar finding its way back towards the bench there. But he'll rectify that. It is nothing major in this particular sport. So we are round two already, and you can see there we've got two athletes still to put a bench on the board. And Malevskis at the top with 235 in the B group in the 93s. We've got Leonardo Quiros Lepas now for 170 kilos. Good open at 165. Oh, he's made it work. Did the bar dip. He has got two red lights there for that very reason. And you can see the bar drop midway through there. Ever so slightly, an excellent pickup from the referees. Antonio Giorgia, 187.5 for Italy. Having to work for it. He had to work every bit of the way for that one, but it pays off. Kombre Orison from Iceland now needs this. He's put 202.5 on, missed his 200. See that shirt compressing his chest. I think he's got that one there. He has three whites. So Enkbata now from Mongolia, 210 kilos. Look good. And his 210 looks pretty solid as well. It is three whites. Doesn't have the cleanest lift. Doesn't really make the most of his shirt, but he is making things work today. Hugo Duarte, Great Britain, 222.5. He has 217.5. That's a good lift from his opener. He has a squat on the board. He is on his way to solidifying a total. And we're quite sure he'd like to add a few extra kilos to it. and just couldn't get to the lockout there. Have a look on the replay and see where it went wrong. Really good touch there. Speed's good. But just couldn't convert at the top. We've got a little bit of room to jack the shirt down a little bit more to get a little bit more speed off the chest. Claudius Malevskis from Lithuania now, 250, making a big 15 kilo jump. And it looks like he's made that work pretty well. He gets the two white lights. Matthew Hallett now for 250. Missed this on his opener. And the jury has overruled the lift from Malevskis. That looks better. I think he's got it. He has three whites. So Hallett gets the 250 while Malevskis has it overruled by the jury. And the overrule was because his head lifted off the bench. The head must stay in contact with the bench. And there is the current standings for Group B on the bench press. Hallett with 250, giving himself every opportunity to get in those top five or six in the bench press when the A group run tonight. Malevskis 235. We move into the final round of bench. Leonardo Quiroz Lepas, Costa Rica, 170. He was unsuccessful at this weight on his second lift. That looks a lot better though. It is three whites. Antonio Giorgia now, Italy, 192.5. Taking his time getting set up there. And just couldn't convert. I think the touch might have been a little bit too easy there. Didn't really have to work through it much at all. Alex Combre Orison from Iceland now, 207.5. Oh, it's a hard touch as well. He gets it to the touch, and there wasn't a lot of speed there. He's having to work very hard. And it's just not going to get to the top.
But he has a lift on the board, and that is the main thing. Ekbatha now for 217.5. He has two successful lifts on the board in the bench press. And just couldn't quite get it there. And he's going to grow in experience over the coming years. This is his first international, I think. And he will gain so much experience. And you can see he just doesn't make the most out of his shirt. And get a lot of speed off the chest. Hugo Duarte now, 222.5. Really want to see him get this lift on the board. He's such a strong lifter and a great character as well. Yeah. 222.5. Unfortunately, just using up a lot of energy already. And his main goal today should be getting a total. Claudius Malevskis from Lithuania now, 255 kilos. Missed his opener at missed his second at 250. Now looking for 255. And just can't lock it out, unfortunately. So Matthew Hallett to finish the round of bench press with 265. And I believe that's the best lift for him. And certainly a best international. 237.5 at the Europeans earlier this year. .230 in Viborg. Looking for 265. Showing some real strength though, just didn't generate much speed off the chest, but what strength to start to push that up. Big effort. And gets a nice little touch there, doesn't really get a lot off the chest, but still managed to press it part of the way. And Matthew Hallett there then with the biggest result in this group with 250. Might be enough to push him up through the rankings. So you do the A group tonight. Don't go too far away, though. We'll be back in 10 minutes, and we've got the deadlift for the 63-kilo women and the 93-kilo men B groups. Welcome back to the Druskininkai, Lithuania, the 2023 IPF World Open Equipped Powerlifting Championships, brought to you by none other than Aleiko and SBD. And we are just about to get underway for the 63 kilo women B group deadlift. And you can see Lucy Hart waiting in the wings there. Very eager to get out for her first deadlift at a World Championships. She's had an outstanding day so far. She's looking for 145 kilos. And there it is. She puts it on the board. She solidifies that total. And now the party begins. Alina Grucha, Lithuania, 160. Everyone just looking to put this first one on the board. And that's a good lift at 160. And good to see Alina making the choice to get move to train conventional there. She's built for conventional deadlift. Vermonti. Julian Skotja, Lithuania, 160. So whether she'll make it out on time, the TC has just sent her back. So obviously something that she was wearing was not compliant with IPF rules. Whether or not she'll have time to fix that and get back out is a whole other story. Unfortunately, I didn't see her in the wing, so I didn't see what it was that was not compliant. But that's why we have technical control there, to make sure that that doesn't happen. And I can see some of the Lithuanians in the crowd talking about it. So that'll be a no lift. And we move to Caitlin Monicki now from the US, 165. If we find out what the issue was, we'll let you know. And just saw the shot of the TC there. I wouldn't argue with him either. And should be a good lift. It is, three whites. And it's a great feeling when you get that deadlift, first deadlift on the board, when you know your total is locked in. So Melody Darman from France now, 170. Got the down command just in the nick of time, I think, with what we see on the replay. Just as she got the down command, looked like she was about to lose a little bit of balance there. But she held it long enough. But Lauren Elder now 182.5. Lifted well above this in the past. Making you look easy. And again solidifies that total. Lucy Hart now out for a second lift. We're already in to the second round.
Yes.
Was a tough pull, and she's got herself into an awkward position now. May not put a deadlift on. Del Monte, Svinskaitia, is in all sorts of trouble. Linda Grutia, 170 now for Lithuania. And fatigue is starting to set in. It's getting tough now. There's not a whole lot left in there. Caitlin Manicki now, 172.5. Should be a good lift. It is. Three whites.
Yes. Three white guys for you. That's the channel. They will need our more calls.
A little bit slower. You'd expect that in a second, especially the end of the day. Melody Darman from France now, 180 kilos. She did a 175 in Viborg last year. Now looking for 180. Oh, those knees locked out early, but she managed it very well. Three whites, and she's pretty happy with that. See the early lockout there, making it really tough, but she straightened up. And Lauren Elder for 192.5. She did a 197.5 in Viborg last year. Certainly wouldn't be surprised to see her try and beat that if this lift is successful. And it looks good. The traditional Lauren Elder belt buckle snap as she walks off. And will she take a crack at the 200 today? We'll wait and see. But right now, Lucy Hart, Great Britain, having a fantastic day, 162.5. This is successful. That will give her a 460 total. I think she's got it there. She has three whites. She has had a fantastic day today. Damonti Julian Skaitia, Lithuania, 165. Had equipment issues on the first lift, so no lift. Didn't make the second lift. She does not get this lift. She does not register a total. She's worked so hard today. Let's hope the crowd gets behind her. She needs this. She needs this to get a total. Oh, I don't think she's got it there. I think she dipped, and unfortunately she has dropped the bar as well. Be an extremely disappointing end of the day for her. But she gave it everything she had on that last lift. And now we see the temp change going in. Okay, then. Maniki has changed hers to 175. Lauren Elder is going to take a crack at the 200 today. I'm happy to see that. And of course, after the third, in the third round, the bar gets cleaned after every lift. Like Caitlin Maniki now, 175. Gonna have to leave everything on the platform for this one. She's giving it everything she's got. She's got it to the top. What do the referees say? It's a good lift. Grutia now, 177.5. Lina has been having a pretty good day today. This will give her a 375 total if successful. Oh, she's giving it everything. Can she lock it out? She's still going. She's got it to the top. And she gets two white lights. What an effort. What an absolute effort. So Melody Darman now, France 185. Looking for a personal best. Just lock those knees a little bit too quickly. But a big, big effort and a great day as well. Gets to the knees really quickly and then just couldn't straighten up. So we load to 200 kilos for Lauren Elder. This will be a best deadlift for her, 200. It'll be fantastic to see her get this one. She's one of those great characters of sport. If you ever see her out the back, she's always laughing. Not so much on the deadlift platform. Oh, just a bit too much today. Huge effort, and that 200 is not far from being hers. So it moved well off the floor, but just couldn't keep the pull going. So she'll finish with 192.5, Kaminsky with 175. And Darman with 180, and of course they're not going to know their overall standings until later this evening. Right now we move straight into the 93 kilo men's B group. Matthew Hallett with 205 to open his deadlift campaign and to solidify that total. And of course the one we're all wanting to solidify is total, Hugo Duarte from Great Britain as well. A 205 for Matthew Hallett. Well within reach. Making it look easy. Three white lights. And I believe he lifted that without a deadlift suit. So Leonardo Quiros Lepes, Costa Rica now, 225. Three whites, another successful lift, solidifies the total. Antonio Giorgia, 250 now from Italy. Making short work of that one. Yes. Three whites. No messing around there. Claudius Malevskis from Lithuania now, 250. Yeah, it should be a good lift. I'd like him to see. I'd like to see him be a little bit more convincing, locking out at the top there, not leaving anything to chance. And that angle from the replay is certainly a lot better. There we go to 260 for Inkbata from Mongolia. Three whites locks that total in. Alex Kombre Orison now from Iceland, 270. This day has been a bit of a mixed bag. And that should be a good lift. It is. He got one red card there. Might have been for a soft lockout. But he's got it on the board. And Hugo Duarte now, Great Britain, 275. And it should be a good lift. It is, three whites, and he locks that total in. And there'll be celebrations in the Great British camp tonight because he has not totaled at international or Europeans for a little while. And he's done his job today. So Duarte with 275, the biggest deadlift in this group. Orison with 270, and then Bata with 260. We move straight into round two with Matthew Hallett, 217.5. Edging pretty close to his best lift now. Another good lift. Only another Kilos Lefis, Costa Rica, 240. Wondering if this is his first World Championships equipped. Oh, he's having to work hard for that lockout. He's just not going to get there. Sorry. To revisit that one on his third. But he has a total locked away. Glorious Malevskis, Lithuania, 262.5. Your lift choices become very difficult for your second deadlift because it's not until you actually get out there you realize how much fatigue has taken its toll on you. But he's handled that well. Three whites.
Yes, the white light for you. Good lift. Let's lift up. Oh, yeah.
Ingvata now, Mongolia, 275. And just a little bit too much, and this is what we talk about with fatigue. You come off after your first deadlift and you feel great and you're excited and you feel a sense of relief because you've locked away that total as well, and then you go out for that second and you realize just how much fatigue has set in. A lift that would usually be well achievable suddenly becomes almost impossible to move. I was going to say it becomes a dead weight, but I thought that was too much of a pun. So 280 on the bar for Antonio Gorga from Italy now. Oh, he made that look easy. Great conventional deadlift. He is absolutely built for conventional. Alex Combre Orison now from Iceland, 282.5. So he has lifted this before, but it was back in 2019, and he hasn't lifted this weight since. He's been 270. This year, 277.5 last year. So it'd be a nice lift for him. And it looks good. It is three whites. Hugo Duarte now, who has locked away his current total at 787.5. This one will take him to 802.5. And I have no doubt he is feeling a real sense of relief. We'll put it all together today. Oh, that looks good as well. How far can he push the deadlift today? Did a 310 at the Classics last year, Arnold Classic last year. Duarte on 290, Orison 282.5, and Gorga on 280. And we go into round three. With Matthew Hallett at 225. Oh, he's got it there. He's locked it. It's three whites. Only another Hiros Lepes, Costa Rica, 247.5. He just couldn't quite get there. His hips popped up a little bit early. But a big effort and a great day. So we go to Claudius Malevskis, Lithuania, 270. For his final lift. This will give him a total of 825. Kyrgios Lepas has then finished on a total of 650. Can he go 3 for 3 on the final deadlift? And the gentle replacement of the bar. Three white lights and an 825 total. Four more lifts to come in this final round. And the 275, just a little bit too much for Ingbata. Finished at a total of 795. Alex Combray Orison now from Iceland, 290. This will give him an 817.5 total. His opener is second, look good. 290 is certainly within reach. Bring a little bit of fire to the platform for this one. This will be a best lift for him as well. He's still squeezing. Can he lock? I don't know if he locked properly. Let's wait and see. The referees say no. It's a no lift, unfortunately, but he gave it everything he could. Just couldn't quite lock it at the top. So Antonio Gorgon now, 300 kilos for Italy. She did a 327 and a half at the Europeans last year, so 300. Clearly didn't cause any issues for him. The final lifter for this round, Hugo Duarte, Great Britain. I'm sure we'll see some celebrations in his camp tonight. He's had a bit of a rough go the last few comps and not put on a total. And today he puts on a total of 812.5 if he gets this lift. Misses this lift, he gets a total of 802.5. Oh, he made that look easy. Three whites. What a great way to finish, and a total of 812.5. That looked just like his other two lifts. And that brings us to the end of this session. So Gorgo with 300, Duarte with 300, and Orison with 282.5. The best three lifters in this B group. And don't go away. Get back here at 7 p.m. local time tonight. We will have the A group for the 63 kilo women and the 93 kilo men. We will be live on Eurosport, and it is not one you want to miss.